हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी ब्रेसनहैम लाइन ड्राइंग एल्गोरिदम, द प्रोसीजर एंड एज वेल एज द सी प्रोग्राम फॉर ब्रेसनहैम लाइन ड्राइंग एल्गोरिदम। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। ब्रेसनहैम लाइन एल्गोरिदम ओके इज फेयरली सिंपल ओके बट इज बेस्ड ऑन डीडीए line algorithms drawbacks. Okay, so we had seen in the last lecture that DDA line algorithm has division operation, and that is why the algorithm is slightly time consuming and it involves unnecessarily more calculations. So to overcome these drawbacks, Bresenham line algorithm is a best choice. And Bresenham line algorithm uses only integer addition and subtraction and multiplication by 2. Okay, so it doesn't involve any division operation, and it doesn't also consist of a rounding of requirement. Okay, so as you would know, in DDA, since we were dividing, okay, so we had to also round off the values by writing a global round off function. Okay, so that is also not required in Bresenham line algorithm since it doesn't involve any division operation. And we also know that computer can perform the operations of integer addition and subtraction very rapidly. So that gives rapidness to this Bresenham's line algorithm in comparison to DDA line algorithm. The computer is also time efficient when performing integer multiplication by powers of 2. So we are using multiplication operation here, but it is only a multiplication by 2. So when it comes to multiplicating by 2, okay, the computer can perform very rapidly. So no question of time delays as far as multiplication operation is concerned as well. And therefore, it is an efficient method for scan converting straight lines. The basic principle of Bresenham's line algorithm is to select the optimum raster location to represent a straight line. Okay, so as you can see, this is the next pixel position. Okay, so we have already come from a current pixel position which is xk comma yk, and now we are in a position to select the next pixel position that can be either in terms of y coordinates, that can be either yk plus 1 or that can be yk, okay, yk plus 1 or yk. This y which has been represented over here is a intermediate position between the two successive y positions for pixel. And in this particular case, as you can see, this line is a hypothetical line which is going to be joining the starting and ending point, okay, and it passes through subsequent pixel location. So as you can see, my xk comma yk position is fixed. Okay, now this particular point is the point through which the line is passing. So this position is my y position. Okay, the current pixel center is my yk, and next pixel center in terms of y is yk plus 1. Okay, now I very well know that in order to represent this line, okay, now this line we have also taken the same slope condition, that is slope is less than 1, okay, slope is positive and it is less than 1, so it is going to be lying in the 0 degree to 45 degree range, okay, of angle. So this is the current position. Okay, now whether to select xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1 as the next pixel position or xk plus 1 comma yk as the next pixel position, that is only the choice that we want to make through Bresenham line algorithm. And in order to do that, we have drawn these two centers. So the bottom center is the center for pixel position xk plus 1 comma yk, that is this, and the top pixel is a center position for pixel xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1. And this particular hypothetical line and this y line, okay, y line, okay, is being shown by this pixel, okay, or this point. Okay, now the line is passing through this point, Now what we do is, from that point towards vertically upward till the center of yk plus 1 and vertically downward till the center of yk, okay, we try to identify the distance. So the first distance we call as d1 and second distance we call as d2. Okay, second distance we call as d2. Now the which pixel will be highlighted is based on the value of d1 and d2. Okay, that pixel will definitely be highlighted, the one which has a smaller value. So if, let's say, by looking at this picture, d2 seems to be the smaller value, so in this particular case d2 is smaller and d1 is larger, so then we will use the values of d1 and d2 to identify the correct pixel position. And the increment in other variable is determined by, so as you can see over here, in order to represent all these pixels, okay, I will always increment x by 1. Okay, I will always increment x by 1. I will have to decide whether to increment y or not to increment y. Okay, so that is going to be decided by these two values, d1 and d2, and that is why the distances, okay, the increment in the y variable is determined by examining the distance between the actual line location and the nearest pixel. Okay, this is the actual line location and the nearest pixel. So that distance we will identify, and this distance is called as decision variable, or it is also called as error. Okay, this is also called as error. So it is shown in, the selection is shown in here. So as you can see, y decision we have to make. Okay, y decision we have to make. So y is given as m x of k plus 1 plus b. So b is a y intercept. Okay, xk plus 1 is the next pixel position in terms of x. Okay, and if we know this, then we can easily find out d1, which is y minus yk, as we can see over here. Y minus yk is d1, and d2 is yk plus 1 minus y. Okay, d2 is what? Yk plus 1 minus y. So the difference between these two separations, okay, difference between these two separations, that is d1 minus d2, if we mathematically try to formulate this, okay, it comes out to be again some sort of equation of line which we can rewrite in mx plus c format, okay, y equal to mx plus c format, and that helps us to find out what is the sign of this d1 minus d2. Okay, what is the sign of this d1 minus d2? If d1 minus d2 is positive, okay, if d1 minus d2 is positive, the line is nearer to the bottom pixel. If d1 minus d2 is negative, the line is nearer to the top pixel. So that decision we can make. And on this decision parameter, the whole algorithm is based on. So let us quickly look at the algorithm steps. So the first step is, input the two line endpoints and store the left endpoint in x0, y0. The load x0, y0 into the frame buffer. Okay, that is, plot the first point. So first point will be readily plotted. Then calculate the constants, delta x, delta y, 2 delta y and 2 delta y minus 2 delta x, and obtain the starting value of the decision parameter as p0 equal to 2 delta y minus delta x. So this p0 is a constant which we have derived from this d1 minus d2. Okay, d1 minus d2. And the first decision parameter is 2 delta y minus delta x. I hope delta y, delta x, what is delta y? Delta y is the difference between the y coordinates, the starting and ending, and that is again the absolute difference, and delta x is a difference in x coordinate, again absolute difference in x coordinate. So first decision parameter comes out to be p0, that is 2 delta y minus delta x. Then the step 4 is the real algorithm step wherein all the decisions are made. So at each xk along the line, starting at k equal to 0, perform the following test. So if my pk, that is my decision variable, is less than 0, the next pixel is going to be xk plus 1 comma yk. So what does this tell us? Xk plus 1 means we are always going to increment x coordinate. So next x coordinate, and we will not increment y coordinate in this particular case. So if my pk is less than 0, so my decision variable is less than 0, okay, I will be selecting the bottom pixel. Okay, I will be selecting the bottom pixel. And if, see, that is natural, if my d1 minus d2 is negative, okay, d1 minus d2 is negative, that tells me d2 is larger, d1 is smaller. Okay, so then only d1 minus d2 will be less than 0, and in that case I will be selecting the bottom pixel. And in the other condition, and then the next decision parameter will be calculated as pk plus 1 as the pk, current pk plus 2 delta y. Otherwise, the next pixel position is going to be the top pixel, that is xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1. And the next decision parameter will be pk plus 1 equal to pk plus 2 delta y minus delta x. And the fifth step is, this fourth step will be repeated delta x times. Okay, fourth step will be repeated delta x times. So let us take a very quick example. We will digitize the line with endpoints 20, 10 and 30, 18. Okay, this line has a slope 0.8, so it falls in our slope condition, that is m should be less than 1 and m should be positive. So it is positive and it is less than 1. We will find the constants. Delta x is 10, that is 30 minus 20, and delta y is 8, that is 18 minus 10. The initial decision parameter can be calculated as p0 is 2 delta y minus delta x. So 2 delta y is 8 into 2, that is 16, minus delta x is 10. So 16 minus 10, 6. So first value of decision parameter comes out to be 6. We'll make this table. So k, pk, and then xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1. Okay. And the increments for calculating successive decision parameters are, we will also find 2 delta y, that is 16, and 2 delta y minus 2 delta x, that is minus 4. So delta y we have already found out, that is 8. So 8 to the 16, that is 2 delta y, and 16 minus 20, that is minus 4. 16 minus 20, that is minus 4. So the first value of p0, I got it as positive. First value of p0, I got it as positive. Okay, so I will be printing which pixel positions. I will be printing xk plus 1. So I will increment xk, and I will also increment yk, because my value is positive. My value pk is positive. Okay, the first case is negative case, and the else part is positive case. Okay, else part is positive case, and when I am going to follow the else part, at that time I am going to increment both the coordinates. Okay, I am going to increment the, both the coordinates. So my pk plus 1 condition comes out to be pk comes out to be positive, so I will increment both. So I have incremented it to 21, 11. Okay, then my next decision parameter I will find out based on this. So this pk is 6 plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. So 6 minus 4, 2. So 2 is also positive. So I will again increment both, that is xk plus 1 and yk plus 1. So it becomes 20 to 12. Okay. And my pk comes out to be, current pk comes out to be 2. Then my k will become 2. And the next decision parameter will be again 2 minus 4. Okay. 2 minus 4. So that comes out to be minus 2. So now my pk is less than 0. So when it is less than 0, I will only increment x coordinate and I will leave y coordinate as it is. So it is 23, 12. I did not increment it y coordinate. Okay, continuing further, the next pixel, next decision parameter will be calculated based on this. So it is minus 2 plus 2 delta y, that is minus 2 plus 16. So it comes out to be 14. Okay, now since it is positive, I will increment both x and y. So 24, 13. And similarly, when I again find out the next pixel position, it comes out to be 14 minus 4, that is 10. Okay, so continuing in this manner, okay, I sometimes increment both, and when my pk becomes negative, I only increment x. Okay, so wherever my pk is negative, I have only incremented x, as you can see, for k equal to 2 and for k equal to 7. And at all other positions, I have incremented both x and y. And when I try to start from, say, 20, 10, which the first pixel I am going to readily print, so 20, 10, and the last pixel is 30, 18. So I have successfully printed all the pixels without actually calculating much. Okay, so the calculations were only addition, subtraction, okay, and multiplication by 2, that we have calculated initially. Okay, so and after that we are not calculating it again and again, and only checking with if and else condition what is the sign of pk. If it is positive, okay, increment both. If it is negative, only increment x. So that gives us a very good logic and a very simple program to execute. And if you just have a look at the program, that is the Bresenham line function, so it follows on the exact similar lines as the algorithm. So this is void line Bresenham, int xa, int ya, int xb, int yb. So I am finding first the dx and dy, that is the absolute of xa minus xb, absolute of ya minus yb. Absolute function works exactly similar as the mod function in mathematics, only calculates the magnitude, okay, and does not calculate the, or does not remembers the sign. Okay, so int p equal to 2 into dy minus dx. Okay, I can write this in a programming language because I know first subtraction will be carried. Okay, subtraction will be carried and then the multiplication will be carried. So in programming language we have sequence of mathematical operators. Okay, so the way mathematical operators are executed, they have a defined sequence. Okay, so then 2dy I am calculating as 2 into dy, and 2dy dx I am calculating as 2 into dy minus dx. So here multiplication will be carried, and here since I have given bracket, so preference will be given for bracket first. So dy minus dx will be calculated and then multiplied by 2. Okay, so I need to use these very carefully. Okay, then I am declaring x, y and x end, and I am going to determine what is a starting point and what is an ending point. So if my x a is greater than x b, that means my starting point will be xb, yb and my ending point will be xa. Else it is going to be the straightforward, that is starting point is xa, ya and ending point is xb. Okay, and after this check I am directly going to print the first pixel. So set pixel generally prints the pixel. We can use other function, that is put pixel, during the program. And the next condition, that is step number 4 in our algorithm, while x is less than x end, okay, while x is less than x end, I am going to increment x, okay, and check the sign of p. So if p less than 0, p equal to p plus 2 delta y. Else I am going to increment y also, and see, as you can see in my while loop I am always incrementing x, okay, but whether to increment y or not, only that I am deciding. So when my p is less than 0, I am not incrementing y. When my p is greater than 0, then only I am incrementing y and finding out the next decision parameter as p equal to p plus 2 dy dx, that is 2 delta y minus delta x, 2 delta y minus 2 delta x, and then printing whatever coordinate I get, okay, and that is the end of the program. So now we will see the program in Turbo C package. Now we will see this Bresenham line drawing algorithm in C package. So in usual manner I have included stdio.h, math.h, conio.h and graphics.h. So void main typically remains the same as we had seen during the DDA algorithm time, DDA program time. So I am inputting the two graphics variable, that is int gd equal to detect comma gm, okay, and then the void line Bresenham function declaration I am making, and I am accepting the four coordinate values, that is xa, xb, ya, yb. So writing an output statement, enter the two coordinates of endpoints of line and storing them using a scanf function inside xa, ya, xb, yb in a coordinate format. Okay, so user has to enter the values as x, y, x, y separately for starting and ending point of line. So I am using %d since the values are integer, the variables are integer. Then I am writing the initialize graphics driver function. Okay, so init graph ampersand gd, ampersand gm, and the physical address where the graphics drivers are stored for this Turbo C package. And making device clear using clear device function, so it will wipe out everything and have a clear device for displaying the object. And then I'm making a function called line brace and passing the four arguments in sequence, that is xAyA, xByB. Okay, then the program transfers its scope into the function, and this is a function definition I have written. So void line brace and int xA, int yA, int xB, int yB. So four arguments of integer type have been passed inside the function. Then I am finding the values as we have seen in the PPT. So int dx equal to absolute of xA minus xB and dy equal to absolute of yA minus yB. The first decision parameter, that is 2dy minus dx, okay, p equal to 2dy minus dx, and the two constant values which are required for us to find out the successive decision parameters. So that also we are finding here, int 2dy, that is 2 into dy, and 2dy dx, that is 2 into bracket dy minus dx. Okay, so the multiplication by 2, okay, is required to be done only at these three calculations. So p calculation, then 2dy calculation, and 2dy dx calculation only requires multiplication by 2. Rest all are only subtractions. Okay, rest all are only subtractions, and there are counter variables. And int x comma y comma x end. Okay, int x comma y comma x end. Now to determine which point to use as start and which point to use as end point. Okay, so we are making these if statements. So if xA greater than xB, that is the first coordinate entered by user is a larger one and the second coordinate value entered by user is a smaller one, then x is going to be xB, y is going to be yB, and x end is going to be xA. Okay, else it is going to be the usual condition. So the starting point will be the smaller coordinates and ending point will be the larger coordinate. So x equal to xA, y equal to yA, x end equal to xB. Immediately we are going to print the first pixel, that is put pixel x comma y comma 29. So 29 is the color code. Now the condition we are checking, while x less than x end. So this is going to ensure the while loop will run delta x times, because now you can see, if my current, let's say I am following the usual condition, so we will be in else part. So if my first coordinates, that is xA, yA, are smaller coordinates, let's say 1, 1, and larger coordinates are 5, 3. So then my xA will become 1 and xB will become 5. So while x less than x end, so that is while 1 less than 5, that means this while loop will run 5 minus 1 times, that is delta x times. So x plus plus, we are going to increment the value of x because we have already printed first pixel. So x plus plus, x is incremented, and we are going to check the sign of p which we have already calculated. So if p is less than 0, then p plus equal to 2dy, that is p equal to p plus 2dy. Okay, else p is positive. So then if my decision variable is positive, I am going to also increment y. So y plus plus. And the next decision parameter for p, that will be calculated as p equal to p plus 2dy dx. Okay, p plus 2dy dx. Okay, once that is done, this loop will run for delta x times, and at every instance it is going to print the successive pixel position, and eventually it will come out of the loop. I have just given a delay for the program to print the pixels. So let us try to run the program. No, there are no errors. So I will now run. I will enter the endpoints as 200, 200, 600, 400. I am giving slightly higher endpoint coordinates so that the line can be visible. As you can see, the line is clearly visible on the output screen with the specified color code 29 in the put pixel command. And as the program and logic exhibits, okay, the program is also very simple to understand, and it only works on if else statements, and we have a counting loop, that is while loop, which keeps the counter and successively prints the next pixel positions. So I hope this Bresenham line algorithm and program, which was done in C package, that is Turbo C package, was understood. Stay tuned for more such programs and algorithms as far as computer graphics is concerned. Thank you very much.